जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस। द ब्रेकअप ऑफ जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू, देर आर थ्री यूनिट्स इन जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू, पॉलिटी, गवर्नेंस, इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस। इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस वी आर डूइंग वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस। सो ट्रेडिशनली दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू is between 50 to 60 marks. If I see the analysis of previous papers for the past 5 years, international relations will carry around 50 to 60 marks. Then when the generally when preparing for the civil services, it is not the hard work but the smart work. Why I am mentioning this particular aspect in this video is, see, you take the ranking essay paper. Ranking essay, we have 125 marks. Actually, the paper is for 250 marks. 125 marks is for an essay related to current events of national and international importance. So, if you prepare well for international relations, you are automatically preparing well for preparing for the ranking essay part. And also, international relations, why a knowledge of international relations, why it is important is, you see the first component of the preliminary, current events of national and international importance. So with this background, we go to analysis of the question. Relations between India and Pakistan have reached rock bottom. Review the recent issues that have contributed to this development. Answer in 150 words. So 150 words means you split up your answer in about 15 lines, 15 to 16 lines. See, when you are doing a question and answer writing practice, you will have to stick to the word limit. The examiner expects you to be precise, and I'm also told that if you exceed the word limit, there is negative marking. So my advice to you people is, instead of 150 words, you write 130 words, nothing will happen. You write 145 words, nothing will happen. See, the moment you cross 150, you get into the problem of negative marking. See, this particular question based on India's foreign policy, the first unit being India and its neighbors. So the analysis of this question for 150 words. First, you see the background of Indo-Pak relations. You see the how both India and Pakistan came into being. Both the countries were under the British, and they emerged out of a period of partition, violent communal conflicts. Now, while India adopted the secularist policy, the democratic principle prevailing in parliament, prevailing in Britain, in Pakistan, it is the reverse. Pakistan, the military and the Islamic clergy dictate foreign policy. So the first part of the answer you have to concentrate on, who determines foreign policy in India, in Pakistan. This will be the introductory part. So in India, we have the parliament, then we have the Ministry of External Affairs. So the Prime Minister, the Council of Ministers, Parliament, so they dictate foreign policy. It is in a democratic approach, whereas in Pakistan, it is the military and the Islamic clergy which dictate foreign policy. Coming to the main part of the question says, relations between India and Pakistan have reached rock bottom. Review the recent issues that have contributed to this growth. So the examiner wants to know what are the issues which have come in the way of good neighborly relations. See, the first point which I could mention is reducing the number of diplomatic missions because of the tensions in the relationship between India and Pakistan. There has been a gradual scaling down of diplomatic missions. So when the diplomatic missions are scaled down, to that extent, the both the countries, the relationships are in a state of flux, are in a state of tension. The second point which I would like to mention, a recent development, of course this is there from the beginning, cross-border terrorism. Pakistan is aiding the militants in Jammu Kashmir to carry out cross-border terrorism, and Pakistan is also aiding the terrorist groups like the Lashkar-e-Toyba, and Pakistan is playing a dominant role with Chinese help in not getting the mastermind of the Lashkar-e-Toyba. So ceasefire, the cross-border terrorism is an important thing which is affecting the Indo-Pak relations. Ceasefire violations, though we have frequent meetings of the commanders of both India and Pakistan, we have peacekeeping missions, committee meetings, in spite of that, ceasefire violations continue to happen. Then territorial disputes. Territorial disputes also, border disputes, they are another cause of concern and affecting the Indo-Pak relations. Treatment of Indian personnel. This is another instance which I'd like to highlight, wherein Indian personnel were spied upon, suddenly asked to leave the country and subject to humiliating conditions. The next important other issues which have developed in recent times, which have contributed to increasing tensions, the Pulwama terror attack, then the Balakot airstrike, these two are recent events which have affected Indo-Pak relations. Now, one issue which has to be highlighted in this answer is the reaction of Pakistan to India declaring, India abrogating Article 370 of the Constitution, which had conferred special status on Jammu Kashmir. Now, the bifurcation of the state of Jammu and Kashmir into union territories of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh, it is an internal matter which Pakistan is not, should not be connected with, but still Pakistan has made an issue of the abrogation of the status of Jammu Kashmir. Another important thing which we should examine is, since 2015, no formal talks have been held between India and Pakistan. That is after the PM visited Lahore. Of course, the inauguration of the Kartarpur corridor is an exception. It is an exception which has paved the way for the Sikh pilgrims visiting the shrine in Pakistan. See, though both India and Pakistan are members of the SAARC, there is no cooperation. In fact, even on critical issues like the corona pandemic, there is no cooperation. See, whereas India has extended enormous assistance in terms of the material and even given medical assistance to many countries, Pakistan did not ask for cooperation. Pakistan did not ask for any assistance, and there is no cooperation in critical issues. You take the locust pandemic. The locust which crossed over from Pakistan entered Rajasthan. See, Pakistan did not share the information with India regarding the locust attack. So, in the answer, we talked about what are the, we had an introductory discussion on we spoke about who determines foreign policy. Then we highlighted the important developments which have affected Indo-Pak relations. Then we also pointed out how though there are matters of emergency issues, like say the corona pandemic, the locust attack, there has been no cooperation between both the countries. What could be the way forward? So when you conclude your answer, you can suggest, in fact, as I told you, the examiner appreciates suggestions, and suggestions will help you get more marks. See, the first thing, India This for friendly relations, because our policy, India's foreign policy, speaks of look east, act east, friendly relationships with the neighbors. So this was an achievement for soft diplomacy when both the countries agreed to the Kartarpur corridor, the construction of the Sikh pilgrimage center. Then another thing which we can do, which we can mention, is removing the non-tariff barriers. So removing non-tariff barriers and customs clearance would help in smoothening the relationship between both the countries. The Indus water treaties, this is another problem which is pending. So this is another issue which has to be settled through negotiations. So finally, I conclude by saying that Pakistan is India's most difficult neighbor. Its strategic significance for outside powers determines India's foreign policy. Then what we could do, what I would like to suggest, is in the conclusion, you can mention how India has taken the initiative, like the soft diplomacy of the Kartarpur corridor, and how some more steps could be taken, like easing trade. See, like we had the bus, then we had the train connected from the border to sectors in Pakistan. So all this is a step which can be taken in pursuit of the friendly policy. And though Pak and India are dominant members of the SAARC, it is because of Pakistan's defiant strategies and Pakistan's refusal to cooperate, SAARC has become a non-starter. See, for a question like this, this much of explanation would do. Thank you.